Live from the SmartWayToBuy.com studios.
Piscopo in the morning, 7:42 on AM 970. The Answer, a jam-packed morning this morning. So happy to have you with us. Very pleased that David Schwartz took the time to join us again. He is the attorney representing Michael Cohen of the Trump Organization. Mr. Schwartz, welcome back to the show, sir.
Good morning, Joe. How are you?
Man, I'm a fan, brother. Let me tell you something. You are great on CNN. You're great. Michael Cohen is a good guy. And believe me, if you're listening and you disagree, you're welcome to call and disagree. But, David, you're doing a great job. Keep the fight going. It's unbelievable what's going on, my friend.
I appreciate it. And it is unbelievable. I feel like I was thrown into a whirlwind, you know.
Yeah.
You know, it's almost like call Bramnick, the attorney that you just advertised for all the normal cases. But if you got a porn star, you know, accusing your client of all kinds of nonsense, call David Schwartz up. You know, that's what this is all about right now. It's
because I tell you that, listening, please, David Schwartz, the fact that Michael Cohen has to get certainly an attorney the magnitude of David Schwartz, there's something wrong here. How do you make? And let me start with this, and then we can talk about CNN. And we could talk about your client and everything. But David Schwartz, how do you make Stormy Daniels just go away, man? This is, I'm telling you, the country's watching this. We can't believe this is unfolding. How are we here? And how do you make sense of it all? And then you have to work around, David Schwartz, the legal ramifications of it all. I mean, I don't even know what to say on the radio sometimes in the morning, you know?
It's beyond legal ramifications. It's lie after lie from this attorney, Michael Avenatti. And, hey, I give him a lot of credit. He's got
great. And he's Italian. Going. David, that sounds like an Italian name. I'm embarrassed to tell you that.
I don't understand why the media is feeding into his nonsense.
Because
he hasn't backed up anything. Like, he leaks out something and, you know, he says thug. You know, he uses thug, and all of a sudden, thug becomes the biggest story in the world. Thug. It goes on TV. Thug.
Michael,
how do you back that up? How do you, what's your proof? And then what do we hear? Oh, you'll hear it on 60 Minutes. It's going to be incredible. What do we hear?
Some random guy
goes up to this woman 12 years ago, all right, in a parking lot, and she's got her daughter there. And he threatens her 12 years ago. What does she do, right? She doesn't run to the police. She goes to her Pilates class. You know? It's absolutely absurd. But the story is absurd in and of itself. But then to call Michael Cohen, to blame it on him, and to make it seem to the American people that Michael Cohen is texting her and calling her and emailing her and doing all these things. Michael Cohen has never spoken to Stormy Daniels. Michael Cohen has never communicated with Stormy Daniels. But this guy just gets up on TV and they feed into him, and he completely defames Michael Cohen. He slanders his credibility. Mike, as you said, Michael is a terrific guy.
Yeah.
You know, he's brash, he's tough, but this guy will give you the shirt off his back. I've known him for 21 years. And he is a loyal guy, and the president's lucky to have him as his personal attorney. I can tell you that.
And I'll tell you, and Michael's lucky to have you, David Schwartz, because I tell you, I sat next to him. I told you at an event, and I wasn't really aware of Michael Cohen too much, but you could see, and I tell you, listening, because David, sometimes people are so anti-Trump they lose their sense of, just common sense. So I saw in the eyes of Michael Cohen, I said, and he was like, his hands are like up, like, look, I'm just trying to do what's right for my client, and there was no animus, there was no hate, there was no meanness there. There was a decent guy. Then you have, David, walk me through this, man, because I'm old and I've seen everything. An adult film star going after the president, and it's become, and God bless you for going on CNN and fighting the fight, brother. That was because they're living for this. And I love Anderson Cooper, by the way. I'm a huge, huge Anderson Cooper fan. Great journalist. How does CNN put him up to that? Don't you think did I have to ask you this on the inside, if you could divulge your confidence, because I know you're a lawyer, you're not going to talk, but did Anderson roll his eyes and go, oh God, what am I doing here? Any of that?
That's not confidential. With the conversation that we had the other night.
Off camera, you know?
Anderson's a great guy.
Yeah.
You know, I was with my family that day and we were running around, so I brought them up to the studio that day. He could not have been more gracious to my daughter.
Look at that. Look at, yeah, yeah, yeah.
And in his defense, you know, he gave me a fair hearing. Like, he allowed me to speak on behalf of my client, you know?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
With that being said, I think it's this whole, and I told him that, I think on the air, I said, this whole thing is below him. He's an iconic journalist. He has handled some of the biggest stories ever. He's been through so much all over the world, and for him to be almost belittled into this story, this non-story, it's belittling. However, I'm told that the ratings, and I don't want to sound Trump-like here, but I'm told that the ratings yeah. were through the roof. And, ratings drive these
exactly.
shows.
And
I have to tell you, Joe, it wasn't my proudest moment sitting there with Avenatti and going back and forth. I know it was good TV. I know everybody said it was good TV.
Yeah.
But as a lawyer, as yeah. an advocate,
yeah.
you know, it just is not my pride to respond to someone saying, you're a thug. He's a thug. You're
yeah,
the friend of
yeah.
a thug.
No,
who needs that? But
I know.
You know, it was needed that I was there, and I was happy to do it for Michael Cohen. But Anderson's a great guy, and
yeah.
I think the world of him. I really do.
All right,
by the way, Joe, to answer
yes.
your question, I didn't even answer your question. He was rolling his eyes. Of course, he was rolling his eyes. He was shaking. He couldn't believe it. In fact, I think it was on TV. Anderson rolling his eyes. And like I said, I brought my wife to the show. She was sitting in the back of the studio.
Yeah.
And like after the first part, I look at Anderson.
Yeah.
I go, look at that woman over there. She's completely mortified. She
yeah,
can't
yeah,
believe
yeah, yeah,
it.
Yeah,
I said.
But I got to tell you, though, man, it was great. It was great TV. $1 million. $1 million. You kept saying $1 million. It was great, man. I'm telling you. But walk me through. So, David, the fact that President Trump didn't sign, just clear that up, that he did not
right.
sign this NDA. But first of all, it's an NDA. She should adhere to the NDA. Those of us in America are saying, well, she signed this. She should keep her mouth shut. I don't understand that. But does it
right.
matter that the president under a pseudonym did not sign it?
I actually think you made a great legal point just now, because forgetting about all the signatures for a second, she performed under the agreement. She received the money. She signed the agreement.
Boom.
And certainly courts, even if say it was defective, courts will still find a contract because there was performance and she accepted the money. Now, with that, so that's even a tertiary argument here. But with that being said, the president did not have to sign, or then president-elect did not have to sign the NDA, because there were multiple signature lines, and Michael Cohen signed for an LLC, EC-LLC. So that was one party. Stormy Daniels was the other party. So there was a signed contract. Yes, there was a line there, and one day you're going to – it's not dispositive of anything, because on the in the contract it says and or. It could be – DD or and or EC-LLC signing on behalf of this. So Michael, as an agent for EC-LLC, signed the contract. Certainly when two people sign a contract, not irregardless of what other signature lines there are, those two parties are bound to the contract. So she's bound to that contract. So I believe this judge will throw it right out. Now, in all candor, I think Michael will be out speaking about this in short order, when he's able to talk about that, he'll give you a little insight as to why he left it open. But he did leave it open because there was a possibility he would have gone to Donald Trump. But in this particular case, he did not. He signed the agreement on behalf of his LLC, which he was legally allowed to do, and he was legally allowed to pay the money to her. There's nothing illegal, improper about any of this when you
yeah.
look at the situation for what it's worth. And
yeah,
by the way, Joe, the
yeah.
fact that Donald Trump didn't sign the agreement, it's just more evidence that Michael never went to Donald Trump about the agreement. That was Michael's job. Michael had great
right.
latitude
yeah.
within that structure to handle things for Donald Trump. And these agreements are signed into all the time.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, I call it legal extortion. All right, people are calling it a hush agreement. I call it legal extortion. This is a woman who had sex one time. She says she had sex one time. By the way, is that an affair?
I
never knew that was an affair.
When
you had sex one time with somebody, that's an affair. You know, they made it seem like it went on for years.
Listen, I know, and then they're making it a political payout. It's like a political payout, and those of us are just going, please move on. Please just go away. David, you know what? You got to come back again, David. Love you on the show, man. And give Michael give Michael our very, very best. Keep the fight, brother. And
I will only if you give Frankie Marano my very best.
I will. I'll give you five burrows. Your very, very best, David Schwartz. And we'll talk soon, my friend. God bless you, man. You. Thanks. David Schwartz right there. He's the attorney representing Michael Cohen. We'll go to Susie Cerrone, and we're running late. I could talk to David all day. What a crazy time. You can't make this up. I don't even want to hear about this stuff. I don't want to hear about it. It's like they put it on prime time. It's like,
yes, I saw him last night.
Well, yep. And this guy's got to fight the fight, you know? And 877-970-2999, give us a call, and you're welcome to join the fray here. Hey, Piscopo in the morning.